Hello and welcome to the 13th day. Time is going so fast. We've almost like covered the first leg, and today we have some very interesting things to cover on in the Sky Reiki. And as I told yesterday, we are doing more of a little bit of theory so that people get to know and understand what are the principles of Reiki and how Reiki can be used even for children. So we have Reiki master teacher. She's Shuchika Rao. Suchika, can we start with few questions today before we give you can give us a short Reiki? Yeah?
Yes. Okay. Sure.
So yesterday we did for, you know, like some upper part of the bodies, you showed how we can do it, you know, and we need to slide our hands. We did for the ears, we did for the temples. So today I wanted to ask you, nowadays, you know, children are facing a lot of issues, especially with the teens in the years, you know, and you are an expert in that. Your niche is you mostly give Reiki to children, or, you know, indirectly, I mean, you heal them, and indirectly to the parents as well, because they have a lot of issues dealing with the children, and they also are in anxiety. And now added to that, has it increased because of the lockdown? Can you share some, you know, your, of course, you know, confidentiality is very high. In Reiki, we don't share any details about the person's name or what from where they come and all that. But as a general knowledge, people want to know, like some of them were asking me, you know, like what exactly, where is the Reiki we heard of so much, you know. So can you just tell how Reiki, how you have actually healed students and children? Can you give some examples?
Yes, thank you, Janvi. I just want to thank you. And the thing is, I have had two, three cases where I have really healed people. And let me talk about that child who was had mostly children whom I dealt with, because I'm a teacher, as I said. So yes. This child this child had come down, parents had come down, because the child was having issues with studies and stuff like that. When she came to me, I realized she was a child. She was the second born in the shadow of the first born, who was a super achiever. So this child already was like, and she was born late. And then everybody was praising her. So she was already in the shell. And she went to a school where the teacher child ratio was 1:50 plus in the class. So can you imagine? Yes, that kind of thing. So where the children are, you like, it's like nowadays the kind of thing. Then when she, so basically the language skills were not there. And when I used to ask her to read, she would just, she used to read, just read three letter words or two letter words, like and off. And then she would look up to me and say, when I ask her to read. So basically she did not know, she could not recognize words, she could not speak. Although she was very verbal, and her skills, verbal skills were okay. Not that she did not know to speak, but when off the class, off studies, she would speak a lot. And she was very curious and stuff like that. At that point of time, initially what I did is I developed a rapport. And while developing a rapport, I used to prepare myself also, and I used to prepare that child. I used to give her distance Reiki before she came. Because their child used to be very scared and had fear and complete dislike for studies. So then at that point of time, I used to give her distance Reiki before she came. When she came, I used to pull her down and we used to do some chatting. And then after that, she came on to stage where I started speaking with her. Where after that, I did sessions with her and also counseled the parents, because parents were extremely paranoid. So she would leave, she would not answer any question. She'd leave the paper blank, because just because she would be asked, why did you make such a mistake? No possible. And she was not even talking to the teachers. So teachers were not, teachers would give a feedback, this child is not responding. So at that point, it took a little time for me, but once I did the rapport, I did Reiki for her. Then in the first, at the end of second month, she was able to read, because wow. the child, she is able to read chapters. Like she would not, she read two chapters, and I would. What we used to do, we used to read half the chapter, and it used to be half she used to read, and she read. We used to take 2-3 paragraphs, and she used to take 2-3 paragraphs. Reading was easy. She used to stuttering and stuff like that, and by the end of the day, that and we used to understand meanings and spellings, her spellings. Of, so all that was organized, and by the end of second month, she had. She used to be able to talk in the class, and she used to answer everything in the class.
Oh my God, that much of a transformation happened. And yes. how old was the child, Suchika? Just give us don't give us name or anything, only the child's age, you know, what age range otherwise, you know.
She was 7.5, because
so pretty young.
Yes, and she was 7.5, and when she came to me, she was, and also the setback was because they relocated from another place, the parents, and she exactly. missed another half year because they were trying to get admissioned into schools.
Okay.
So everything was poor thing, that child had come completely, and now, God. And the third month, they have this fun Friday, then they are asked. Every month at the end of the month, they are supposed, they are given a topic. Mm. They are supposed to write something and talk in front of the whole class. With all the teachers, they have this thing in the school.
Yeah.
So, she wrote her own topic and she spoke in front of the whole class. So, mother was like, damn thrilled. Yeah. And now, and I was like, it was such a pleasure for me because I saw her grow. And yeah. I also sometimes get baffled by the amount Reiki can help us.
Yes.
Because in this I also grow. Because as a person, I realize Reiki is wherever you can use it, it is amazing. So now I used to also counsel the talk to the parents in the same breath, because parents just want children to achieve. And this child was very good at storytelling. So she started writing small stories also. Okay. And she would draw something, and she used to write one page. Even if that one page for that child is quite a big thing. And she would write to me, and she used to come and tell me, this is my story today. And wow. she even gifted me a bookmark which she made herself. Uh-huh. With writing something on it.
So sweet.
This is something which I really appreciate, and I realize that a lot of parents are facing such issues, and there are two, three more cases which I have.
Maybe we can discuss it tomorrow, and because you know that's what you know when the video is published. I want the parents and the students who are sitting at home to realize that most of the things, such things happen because of the parental pressure, and it's an kind of, you know, expectation which is unmet expectation from the parent, which somehow subconsciously it goes to the child. They may not tell that, but then the child comes to know, you know, children are very, very sensitive to such things. And Reiki can actually heal the child completely and cure all these and actually nip it in the bud. I mean, this happened at such a young age. Imagine if the child had gone through this issue without the Reiki healing for another 10 more years, or even 5 more years, or even 1 more year, the child's psyche would have got affected.
She does homework by herself. She does her homework by herself. Otherwise, her father and mother all used to sit with her, and she's never motivated to learn.
Yes. Clearly.
And it's like for me, it's a boon, because I feel grateful for the boon of Reiki. Yes.
Absolutely. So, Suchika, I really want to thank you for being on this Story to Satori show and sharing those wisdom nuggets. So, would you like to end with a very quick 2-minute? We have only 2 minutes for you have a Skype session now. Suchika is the busy person who has the Skype session. Can you give us 2 minutes of just one position, Reiki, you know? Yeah.
let us do the heart chakra. Is that okay, or what do you want?
Yes, yes. Anything. I mean, you feel. You know, it's you are the person who's leading this session.
Maybe we can. We will do the heart chakra because we need the heart to be healed because we are going through a lot of emotions now.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Let us place our hands over the heart chakra and visualize the light. I shall do the symbols now. Let us thank Reiki to begin with and thank our gurus and guides in our minds. And thank you, Janvi. And thank you. Thanking all the people who are part of this session for being here. Just imagine the light transcending from the from above and entering the heart chakra. See, try to visualize the green color light of the heart calming us down, opening up into a beautiful eight-petaled lotus. This chakra being the center of all emotions, love, center where all the 40,000 neurons connected with them, with emotions are based. Feel the green light. Visualize each and every cell of your heart getting purified, cleansed, and bringing joy with every moment of this life. The life force energy healing us. When you have feel that the heart chakra has become, the light has become translucent, transparent, as all the fogginess and the negative low energies have gone back to the source as a love and light, gently open your eyes. Take your time if you feel that you need it. When you are ready, open your eyes. Thank you, Reiki. Thank you, Reiki. Thank you, Janvi. Thank you, Guru.
Thank you, Shikha.
Thank you, Janvi.
Thank you so much. Yeah. And today's was very, very useful. I'm sure, you know, a lot of children may be facing these issues, and definitely they can benefit by getting in. Please get in touch with Shuchika Rao. She's an expert in healing children, and mostly she does for children's teens. And tomorrow she'll be again taking up another of one of her experiences she'll be sharing. So thank you for being on Story to Satori show. Thank you, Shuchika.
Thank you, Janvi. Thank you, lovely. Thank you. Appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.